Good afternoon, sir.
How are you?
I am great, sir. Thanks.
You know, the other day, my daughter asked me a question. She asked me, how many months have got 28 days? How many months have got 28 days? I told one, and she told that I was mistaken. I don't know what the mistake is. Anybody knows the answer?
12 months.
Yes, it's all the months. I think Rajkumar told, he gave the first answer. Oh, why don't we give him a round of applause? Good, Rajkumar. Fine. Let me ask you a question. Divya, how did you clap?
With my hands.
So you clap. Fine. Or you or I? Clapped.
With my hands.
With my hands. Mr. Francis, how did you applaud Rajkumar?
With clapping hands.
Let us see. Applauded him with clapping hands. Now, I want you to observe these two sentences carefully. I clapped with my hands. I applauded him with clapping hands. Do you know, or do you believe that both the statements are correct? You know, the first one is right, and the second one is wrong. Clear? You know, this arises because of a small confusion. Let me be more clear. I'll write four sentences. I want you to pay attention to all the four sentences. I learn English by reading books. I learn English with reading books. I write with a pen. I write by a pen. Look at these four sentences. I learn English by reading books. I learn English with reading books. Which one is the correct sentence? Is it I learn English by reading books or I learn English with reading books?
By
reading books. If your answer is I learn English by reading books, then you're right. And if your answer is I learn English with reading books, you're wrong. I write with a pen, I write by a pen. Which is the right sentence?
First one.
I write with a pen. If your answer is I write with a pen, it's a correct sentence. And if you write I write by a pen, it's a wrong sentence. You know what's the reason? I'll tell you later. All this arises because of a confusion. You know what the confusion? Confusion between by or with. The answer is I learn English by reading books and not I learn English with reading books. The answer is I write with a pen and not I write by a pen. Clear? Because the confusion arises because of a similar thing. All these four statements are answers for a single question. How? How do you learn English? I learn English by reading books. How do you write? I write with a pen. Clear? Let me be more clear. Let us look at these two sentences. I clapped with my hands. I applauded with him with clapping hands. When we look at the first sentence that I wrote on the board, I learned English by reading books. Look at the sentence carefully. You know, by is always followed by verb, because by reading is a verb, and after verb it is not simply verb, it is also followed by an ing form plus ing. Clear? We don't use verb plus ing with the word with. It is only by the preposition by. Am I clear? In the previous classes we have learned prepositions, and which we have dealt with by and with. By is used with an agent and with is used with an instrument. And this is a small confusion. Clear? So this is a rule that I want you to remember. Clear? By, verb, and ing. So what is the right sentence then? I learned English by reading books. So where is Francis? Francis, your answer was this. I applauded him with clapping hands. So can you correct your answer now?
I applauded him by clapping.
Exactly, you're right. I applauded him by clapping hands. So whenever you come across a verb and ing, you must use
by.
Let me write one more sentence.
Sir, Rama was killed by Rama.
Sir.
Then which come? Then what is the rule, sir?
That's a passive voice. I shall also talk about it later. Okay? After this, because this will confuse you. After this, I shall definitely talk about it. Okay. He hit the nail with his hammer. He hit the nail by using his hammer. Can you tell me which is the right sentence? He hit the nail with his hammer. He hit the nail by using his hammer.
Both are right.
What is it we have learned today? We have learned that whenever we use verb and ing, we must use by. Clear? For example, if I say, how did you cut the apple? I cut the apple with a knife. Or you can also say, I cut an apple, or I cut the apple with a knife. Or you can also say, I cut the apple
by using a knife.
Clear?
Yes.
I'll ask you.
You said using is a verb.
Yes.
Is it a main verb?
Supporting verb. Okay? Use plus ing. Okay. I want you to look at this photograph. I think this is a dog. Okay? A leash is also attached to this dog. And I'll ask you a few questions I want you to answer. Okay? Please identify which is the right sentence. We exercise our dog by walking every day, or we exercise our dog with walking every day?
By walking every day.
I'll ask you one more question. We control our dog with a leash, or we control our dog by a leash?
With a leash.
Yes, we control our dog with a leash. One more question. We train our dog with love and discipline, or we train our dog by love and discipline?
With love.
Yes, we train our dog with love and discipline. Now we will do a very short activity. And I want you to answer me. I'll show you an object and I want you to give the answers. By using by and with. My first question is to Mr. Solomon.
Sir.
Please stand up. How do you unlock the drawer? How do you unlock the drawer?
By using the key.
Wonderful, exactly. Please clap for him. By using the key. Or I can also say...
With key?
Yes, with the key. Please clap for Chandrasekhar. You are on the way. My next question is to Jay Prakash. Please stand up. Jay Prakash, you know this is a mouse. It doesn't have any life. Fine. Okay, how do you move the cursor on the computer? You must answer with the help of this. How do you move the cursor on the computer?
I move the cursor.
Yes.
By moving the mouse.
Yes, I move the cursor by moving the mouse. Please clap for him. And Rajkumar, can you use the word with?
With mouse.
Yes. I move the cursor with a mouse. One more question. How do you put papers together? Divya, how do you put papers together? Using this object. How do you put papers together? It's a stapler. Stapler in machine.
By stapling.
Yes, we put the papers together by stapling it. Any other answer? With?
Stapler.
Yes, with? Staple. Right. Chandrasekhar is enthusiastic. I would like to ask him one more question. How would you reattach a postage stamp?
By using the stick?
Yes, by using the fevi stick or by using the gum. Any other answer?
With?
Gum. Exactly. How do you cut the paper into two? How do you cut the paper into two?
With the scissors.
Right. With the scissors. Or?
By using
scissors. How do you measure a paper or anything?
By using a scale
or?
With a scale.
Thank you. We have come to know that when we use by, when we come across a verb plus ing, we must use by and not with. I think our confusion got rectified. Okay. I also have some tasks to you. We will do this as a home task. There's a passage and you have 5 questions on the passage. I want you to read them carefully and answer them. We will have a discussion tomorrow in the class. Thank you.
Rajkiran, you did your B.A. That's very much evident then. Your parents are living over there and I should congratulate you. The lesson was very much interesting. Initially, you took examples from the students by posing some questions. An inductive way of teaching grammar, preposition, whatever. I like this aspect of taking the examples and putting them on the board and then making an analysis. This is a good aspect in your lesson, but there are a few shortcomings also. The second sentence, that is, I applauded him with clapping hands. That one, you did not make an analysis. You simply said it is wrong. And then you didn't give answer why it is wrong. Later you get the explanation. But initially you put a wrong there. And then you said that it is wrong. And in the middle there was a confusion. Because you were giving some rules. And the class, you know, was totally silent. And I think the students felt it monotonous explaining the rules. And there was no interaction with the students. You were talking about by plus V plus ING and so on. There was some kind of silence and the students did not like you teaching that particular aspect of grammar. But later, when you taught the rule and then when you gave the examples, started giving the examples, they interacted with you, and when you took out the box and then you showed different objects, then once again it gained momentum and there was a lot of interaction going on, and the students did like that aspect of your lesson. This is what I felt. And in the middle, I told you that there was some silence. That could have been avoided by taking examples again from there. By having the interaction with them, asking them to correct the sentence themselves, why it is wrong, instead of you giving the answer. That's the only thing I think that's the only thing you have to correct. Thank you.
I have only English to tell, sir. I have a man here who is irritated. The second one, actually, wanted to give the full meaning or give the full understanding later. We'll have added one sentence. That is, I'll tell you later. We'll have added one sentence. And one small spelling mistake, we're not wrong.
Have
one, you wrote wrong.
I think we can also add something. Is when Mr. Jayaprakash asked a question to you, what part of speech is using, you said it's a verb, and you said it's a helping verb. It's not a helping verb. It's a supporting verb. Supporting verb or helping. It's not helping.
It comes up as supportive action.
What is supporting?
Gerund,
is it?
Using. So you mean, you know, convince Mr.
Jayaprakash
by giving the right answer.
Okay, my feedback. Good lesson. Neatly delivered, systematically delivered. You had a very simple purpose. The fundamental difference between the two prepositions, by and with. Through a variety of activities, you brought out the difference. I liked it. A good lesson. Congratulations. I'm not going to be so mean as to point out minor problems. I'll just ignore them. It was a very good lesson. Congratulations.
1 point in the top. Actually, the last question is called Mandisuri Mandisuri. Maria Mandisuri. She introduced the teaching by using the objects. Kids,
you are teaching
him, sir. Even that type of methodology we use in remaining classes also.
Mandatory. So what?